In this video, I'm going to compare radiant barrier foil to radiant barrier paint. Now, in full disclosure, obviously, as the owner of atticfoil.com, I sell radiant barrier foil. I'm not really here to try to knock the radiant barrier paint. I just want to give you facts and information so that you can make a good decision on what product is right for your home. I used to be an installing contractor. I've personally sprayed hundreds of homes, and so I am qualified to explain the differences. First, let me talk about radiant barrier foil. Radiant barrier foil is made by taking pure aluminum and rolling it out into a very thin sheet. By doing this, it has the ability to reflect 97% of the radiant heat, just like a mirror, or to only convert about 3% of the stored energy to radiant heat. This is kind of like wrapping a potato with foil. Obviously, a potato with foil will stay hot longer than a potato that's not wrapped with foil. This is called the emissivity quality. Now, this is a known property. You may have heard that NASA developed radiant barrier or radiant barriers. And yes, NASA did develop radiant barrier technology. This is true. But the product or radiant barrier has been changed and evolved into many, many different products. You see it in fire suits. You see it in fire tents. You even see it inside of potato chip bags. It's an undisputed art that pure aluminum reflects 97% of radiant heat. Okay, so let's talk about radiant barrier paint. First of all, how is the paint made? All products are a little bit different, but basically what they do is they take pure aluminum and grind it into a very fine powder. This powder is usually added to a water-based paint. The paint is sprayed up in the attic. After the paint dries, you are left with a layer of aluminum pieces. So essentially what the paint's trying to do is recreate a layer of foil. In theory, if it worked that simple, the paint would be a great product. The one big advantage that paint does have over foil is that it can be installed very quickly. Here are some differences between radiant barrier paint and radiant barrier foil. First of all, radiant barrier paint technically is not even a radiant barrier. Radiant barrier by definition is a product that either reflects over 90% or has an emissivity quality of less than 10% or emits less than 10% of the heat. Radiant barrier paints are technically called interior radiation control coatings, or IRCCS for short, since they do not achieve the 10% emittance standard to be called a radiant barrier. In fact, if you look at the testing done by REMA International, only 4 out of the 18 products even meet the definition of an IRCC, which is less than 25% emittance. And in fact, some companies will take these products and rebrand them with their own labels, and this makes it extra difficult to find any technical information on them. You may hear that some radiant barrier paints advertise that they reflect 75% of the radiant heat. Now understand, this is if they paint the complete roof deck and the complete rafters. Most spray jobs only cover the bottom of the deck and they flash the rafters, which means they only paint down about an inch or two. This allows what's called thermal bypass. Basically, this is the heat from the roof is still conducted through the rafters and then it's re-radiated into the attic, essentially bypassing the paint. In comparison, the foil is either stapled to the bottom of the rafters or it's laid out over the attic insulation. This eliminates all the thermal bypass through the rafters. The next big variable is the installation itself. Is the paint being put on too thin or too thick? From experience, I know that some guys will run it out too thin. This paint is not cheap, and some guys will actually double the recommended coverage. It's really hard to tell just by looking. Finally, have you ever tried to actually paint raw wood? This is the bottom of your roof deck. It's not smooth. In fact, the wood is really porous and it'll just suck up the paint. The test values that you see are conducted on a smooth surface, which is not your roof deck. In order to create that smooth surface, you would need to pre-paint or prime the wood. So in summary, to get a true comparison between the paint and the foil, you've got to do all of the following. First, you've got to use one of the only 4 products that meets the requirements to be an IRCC. Second, you've got to pay extra to have the complete rafters painted. Then you have to have a paint applied the correct thickness and coverage, and you probably have to pay extra to have the wood primed to create a smooth surface to ensure minimum emissivity. So if all these variables are met, the absolute best case is still about 75% reflectivity or 25% emittance. Foil gives you 97% reflectivity or 3% emittance every time. With all these variables, the true reflectivity of radiant barrier paint is probably in the 20 to 40% for most jobs. It's not even close to the 75% advertised. Finally, I hate to bring it up, but I want you to be fully informed. Some contractors cheat with paint. As I mentioned, the paint is really expensive, and some guys will either add water or mix in some cheap paint to make it go further. I know there are many honest contractors out there, but it's just one more potential variable that can affect paint. I hope this video provided you some good information comparing radiant barrier paint to radiant barrier foil. For more information on do-it-yourself radiant barrier foil, visit atticfoil.com. For complete information on installations, pictures, tips, tricks, or to order online.